swing, a long drive. We're back, let's go!
Black baseball players were left out of the major leagues in the early 20th century, so they organized their own teams.
And I hope that someday the names of Satchel Paige and Josh Gibson in some way can be added as a symbol to the great Negro players that are not here only because they were not given a chance.
Andrew Rube Foster, the father of black baseball.
In 1920, Foster founded the Negro National League, which flourished throughout the decade.
Leroy Satchel Paige, arguably the Negro League's hardest thrower, most colorful character, and greatest gate attraction.
Josh Gibson was the greatest power hitter in black baseball. James Cool Papa Bell was arguably the fastest man to ever play professional baseball.
But the great Oscar Charleston, perhaps the greatest all-around baseball player that game has ever seen.
Buck O'Neill was a great player.
He gave the Negro Leagues a level of credibility that it had not seen before.
Effa Manley, the first and so far only woman to be enshrined in Cooperstown.
Manley established the precedent that major league clubs should respect the contracts of the Negro League.
In the mid-1940s, Branch Rickey, general manager of the Brooklyn Dodgers, began making plans to recruit a player from the Negro Leagues. Rickey set his sights on Jackie Robinson.
Mr. Rickey, do you want a ball player who's afraid to fight back?
I want a ball player with guts enough not to fight back.
But 1947 marked a turning point when Jackie Robinson appeared in a Major League Baseball game, breaking the league's color barrier.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rickey. I'm certainly delighted with my contract.
Soon, more black baseball players would join the newly integrated MLB.
The first African-American player in the history of the American League, Larry Doby, was a power-hitting center fielder.
Ernie Banks, the great shortstop for the Chicago Cubs.
With Roy Campanella, a mighty hitter, and behind the plate, the mainstay of the team.
On the mound, Don Newcomb was as good as they came. He broke in at a time when black players had to be more than good enough.
Monty Irvin fashioned a career of dual excellence in both the Negro Leagues and the Major Leagues.
Minnie Minoso broke the color line for the White Sox when he joined the team in 1951.
Elston Howard, he was the first African-American to play for the Yankees.
This is the fame you like. Willie Mays, one of the Giants.
We were not able to stay with our teammates. We wasn't able to change clothes in some of the ballpark for our teammates.
We got letters. If you so-and-so show up today, we're going to kill all of you. I had to pitch that game.
That bench seat was empty, so I sat down. It was in the front of the bus. And the driver looked at me eye to eye and said, get in the back, boy.
You realized that they were not right, but by the same token, you felt like you had to do them in order to make things better for someone else who was coming behind you.
Negroes than ever before played in organized baseball. It's a true parade of progress.
Robinson was named National League MVP in 1949, leading the loop in hitting at 342 and in steals with 37 while knocking in 124 runs.
And Frank rips into this one. It's in there for a home run.
Howard's historic 1963 campaign featured one of his 9 All-Star appearances and his first of 2 Gold Gloves.
Snellish, there goes number 400. But Big Frank, you can put it on the board. Yes!
And a high fly ball belted. Number 56, fly, fly away.
Renowned for his baseball smarts, Joe Morgan could single-handedly beat opposing teams with his multifaceted skills.
Last year's American League home run champion, Jim Rice, is ahead of the pack this year in both home runs and RBI.
It's another home run. Versailles, key man all year for the Twins.
He led the National League in batting 4 years in the 60s, MVP of the league. 1966.
Mr. Cub became the first National Leaguer to win the MVP award in consecutive years.
He has become not only the face of the Pittsburgh Pirates, but the face of Major League Baseball.
What a stop by Pendleton. He got him for the out. That was spectacular.
He got a triple! Oh, Jimmy Rollins with that big 20th triple of the year.
Maury Will-o'-the-Wisp Wills provided more diamond thrills than any player in the game.
The first 30-30 shortstop in the history of Major League Baseball.
The most valuable player in the National League, right fielder Dave Parker.
and the MVP of 1967, Orlando Cepeda.
Dick Allen was a very good ball player. Six seasons with 30 or more home runs and an MVP award in 1972.
Willie Stargell, the big man. He's the spirit, the soul of the club.
Red Sox Mookie Betts was named most valuable player in the American League.
Driven deep, gone, 59. What a show he is putting on.
He stole it. The American League record for Ricky Henderson.
And the American League home run king, Reggie Jackson.
Would you say he's a little fired up?
What a throw by Andre Dawson.
There's a drive to deep left field, and Guerrero's done it again.
Well hit to the opposite field. Out of here, Ryan Howard.
There it goes. Staring into history. Aaron Judge is the American League single season home run leader.
What a marvelous moment for the country and the world. A black man is getting a standing ovation in the Deep South for breaking a record of an all-time baseball idol.
And Bonds hits one high. It is out of here!
Well, that's goodbye, number 600 for Willie Mays and the bye-bye Baby Bonanza.
It is 600 for Southside.
Alex Rodriguez, the youngest man ever to get to 600 home runs.
Number 30 touches them all, and boy, what a Father's Day gift for senior.
Pujols sets one in the air. It's 700! Albert Pujols!
Bob Gibson posted a 1.12 ERA in 1968, the lowest figure since 1914.
The first player in baseball history to win the Cy Young, MVP, and Rookie of the Year honors in their career.
The Black Aces, black pitchers who have won more than 20 games in one season.
Strike three, ball, strike three. It's a no-hitter for Jones.
The pride of both the Dominican Republic and the Giants, Juan Antonio Marichal Sanchez, won 243 games.
James Mudcat Grant. Mudcat was the first black pitcher to win 20 games in the American League.
Fergie Jenkins used pinpoint control and effectively changed speeds to win 284 games.
Strike three, and it's perfect, because the greatest closer in history now has the most saves in history.
Swing and a miss, he got him. Strikeout number 3,000 for C.C. Sabathia.
Vida Blue, the sensation 21-year-old left-handed pitcher,
James Rodney Richard.
If you wanted one pitcher to start a big game, it would be Louis Tiant. Nobody was a tougher competitor or a better teammate.
There it is, Dontrell Willis with a one-hit shutout.
What a performance by this rookie left-handed.
For Pedro Martinez with 17 strikeouts in 1999, you talk about domination.
Roy Gooden, 19 years of age, has set a new Major League record for strikeouts by a rookie pitcher.
And the Rays are in the postseason. David Price goes the distance.
It's a Marlins win, and it's a shutout for Sandy Alcantara.
And what a throw by Dave Parker, who continues to show why some people consider him the greatest player in the game.
There's a long drive. That one is going way up. That hit the transformer up there.
It's gone. A home run for Leon Wagner. The American League goes out in front, 3-1 on a two-run homer.
He's hit it out.
And look at that one. Bo Jackson says hello.
But look at George Foster. He leads the major leagues and runs batted in.
Bond's tremendous home run extends the National League lead to 5-1.
Oh, what a catch by Torrey Hunter. Pedro Martinez, the first time ever that the first three hitters have gone down on strikes.
Alfonso Soriano delivers a three-run homer. It is 6-0 American League.
She's gone!
It's tied at seven.
It's a leadoff triple for baseball's best hitter.
A base hit puts the American League on top as Frankel came through.
Garrett Anderson has homer. A two-run shot, and it's 5-3.
A quiet and effective leader, Hammer and Hank Aaron, and appeared in a record 24 All-Star games.
He's now got 13 All-Star game hits. He was the MVP of the All-Star game back in 2000. And, goodbye! Wow! What a catch by Carl Crawford to start the seventh.
Jackie Robinson burst onto the scene in 1947, bringing the Negro League's electrifying style of play to the majors.
Rock has now stolen 893.
I'm the greatest of all time. Thank you.
Tim Raines has joined the most elite of clubs, his 800th stolen base.
100 stolen bases for Vince Coleman, a remarkable weapon.
Joe Morgan was a terror on the base paths, topping the 40 steal plateau 9 times during his career.
And Lofton has stolen a new Cleveland Indians career record.
Not in time, and there's number 600 for Juan Pierre.
A young Dodger shortstop named Maury Wills, pilfering more bases in a single season than Ty Cobb himself.
And not in time, and Reyes has his 500th career stolen base.
And Rajay Davis is going to steal it easily. And Davis gets stolen base number 50.
Stolen base number 40 for Jimmy Rollins.
Just tied the modern major league record of 6 stolen bases by Otis Nixon.
Carl Crawford steals his 6th base of the afternoon.
The first man in the history of the game to have 500 steals and 500 plus home runs.
He had 12 gold gloves in a row. That's the most in the outfield tied with Mays.
Throughout his 22-year Major League career, there seemed to be no shortage of ways in which the Say Hey Kid could take over a ballgame.
And he's got it! An incredible catch by the kid!
Kansas City's Negro League Baseball Museum and Rawlings are teaming up. The museum in Rawlings will announce 9 Negro League Gold Glove winners.
Everybody was mad at me because I was catching the ball one hand, but I anticipate with one hand and I can make the play much better.
It's from the outfield grass.
Paul Blair, the retired Baltimore Orioles center fielder and 8-time Gold Glove winner.
Bill White was a trailblazer. He was a first baseman, a broadcaster, and the National League president.
He's picked by Derek Lee. Sensational play. And the Marlins take a lead in this World Series, 3-2.
He's at the wall, and he caught it!
What a double play!
You're not going to see any better. I'll guarantee you that.
Rubin, he makes the play! Come on in!
You've got to be kidding me! One of the best plays you will ever see!
He caught it!
The 8-time Gold Glove winner and Royals Hall of Famer Frank White is beloved in Kansas City.
It was caught by Wells. Wells jumped over the fence and came back with a ball. I almost don't believe it.
What a play by Jackie Bradley Jr. He's out! Mookie Betts
fired a strike down to second base.
Holy cow! What a throw! Unbelievable! I want to see him. Hudson, a diving play. Got it!
Oh, what a play!
Andrew Jones. Oh, good night. That's why that man's a gold glover. I mean, that saved 3 runs.
He caught it. He robs him of a home run. Oh, my. Get out of town.
Winning those 4 gold gloves, my first 4 in the big leagues, probably meant the world to me.
Oh, my. What a play by Adrian Beltre. 25-year-old Adrian Beltre. Oh, leaps up. He got it.
He's a 9-time All-Star, 9-time Gold Glover.
On a throw by Hayward. You're not going to see a better throw right here.
Kendrick.
High fly ball to left and goodbye.
How about Cueto? Royals up 2-0.
Sparked by Robinson, the Dodgers win the 1955 World Series.
Indian Dolby rockets Sane's high, fast pitch for a trip to Mars. Dolby's round trip is the first home run of the series.
The Cardinals are the new world champions. Gibson, Boyer, and McCarver join in a big bear hug.
All eyes key on Bob Gibson, who established a new record for the lowest earned run average in National League history. It's a record 17 strikeouts.
And Robbie blasted deep to left. It's a home run. That's number two for Robbie in the series.
That is hit well. A Clemente home run, and the Pirates lead 1-0.
Joe Black, at age 28, joined the Brooklyn Dodgers and became the first African-American pitcher to win a World Series game.
Let's have another look at that spectacular play.
So A.G. is going, and A.G. takes it down and gets out.
Willie McGee, with the bat and with the glove, has been a one-man show tonight.
And we'll see you tomorrow night.
That's up the middle, and the White Sox take the lead. Jermaine Dye.
The Yankees are back on top. World champions for the 27th time.
Strike, and the Reds are two outs away. 20 in a row, 9 strikeouts.
Ball game is tied.
He strikes out the side for the second time in 3 innings.
Well, congratulations. A great series. You're the most valuable player.
Thank you, Don. And I can't think of any series that was exciting as this one.
High fly ball to left center. At the wall. Grand slam.
And the Reds have the lead 4-3 as Joe Morgan looped a base hit into center field.
The Florida Marlins have won the World Series. Terry Womack delivers. It's 2-2.
And there's a shot to left field to put Boston on top. Manny Ramirez lost it into the seats and left. And it's gone. Red Sox lead it 2-1.
Top of the 10th inning, a rain delay. You call a team meeting.
I just had to remind them who they were, what we were coming to get here.
Dexter Fowler, hello, in game 7. 1-0 Chicago.
A home run by Derek Jeter. He is Mr. November.
It's a 2-run double for Dave Winfield and a 4-2 Toronto lead.
Yvon, congratulations on 2 clutch, gritty performances, which propelled your team to victory. Your most deserving MVP.
And he launches one to deep right field. She's gone to tie it.
That one is gone over everything. Perez slammed it over the screen, and now we have another 1-run ball game.
That's a shot into the gap in left center. Kane is emptied up, and the Royals have blown it open in the 12th.
Touch them all, Joe. You'll never hit a bigger home run in your life.
Oh, what a blow! Forget about who the most valuable player is in the World Series.
William essentially became the first African-American and most likely the only former slave to play on a Major League Baseball team.
Buck Leonard. Leonard was always an advocate for civil rights.
Judy Johnson was a key member of some of the greatest teams in Negro League's history.
Willard Brown regularly posted batting averages well above 300.
Dan Bankhead was probably in the mid-40s, the most dominant pitcher in black baseball.
Tall, hard-throwing right-hander Smokey Joe Williams dominated early 20th century black baseball.
Junior Gilliam, and he smashed a home run into the left field stands to tie the record.
Joe Pumpsy Green, he became the first African-American to play for the Red Sox.
A superstar who has an inside track on reaching the Hall of Fame, Tony Oliva.
Billy Williams, the 6-time All-Star, was the National League's Rookie of the Year in 1961.
The Dodgers have batted triple.
When Emmett Ashford became Major League Baseball's first black umpire.
When that ball is in astro orbit, and Wynn hit it over that point.
He got it! It's a
it's all over, and Wilson has pitched a no-hitter.
Three, Willie Horton played 15 seasons in the Motor City.
A really gritty, get-dirty kind of player who could do almost anything on a baseball field. Yeah.
This guy was so integral in baseball.
And the guys that are playing today are indebted to this man to have the ability to choose where he works.
Still going back. It's gone! A grand slam home run!
Page was elected to the Baseball Hall of Fame in 1971.
The first Negro League player to be inducted into Cooperstown.
For the first time in the major leagues, all nine guys in the starting lineup were either black or Latino.
Frank Robinson, Major League Baseball's first black manager.
Bill was the highest-ranking African-American in all of Major League Baseball.
Lyman Bostock was a ball player with a fast bat and a burning talent.
Hendricks throw! He got him!
Ellis Valentine, who had one of the best arms in the history of baseball.
Base hit, Brewers lead.
Sweet Lou Whitaker! And it's gone!
You're looking at one for the ages here.
High drive into deep right field, gone!
Did he hit that on top?
To deep left field, gone!
Harold Douglas Baines, one of the most consistent and reliable players of the 1980s and 1990s.
Going for the cycle. Eric Davis, how many times do you see that?
Home run number 50 for central fielder.
Jelly Davis launches one. 2-0, Minnesota.
There's Ron Gant's first ever grand slam.
Well, I want to present you, Cito, this World's Championship trophy.
It's gone, a grand slam home run. The magic continues.
Eddie sends one to deep right field.
This is why he's one of the great center fielders in the game.
A band leader who built great teams, a trailblazer who opened the door for others.
In honor of Jackie, Major League Baseball is taking the unprecedented step of retiring his uniform number in perpetuity.
Bonilla sends one out of here. This ball is a grand slam home run.
Birdie way up front of play. The play of the game.
This day serves as a constant reminder to continue to educate people on what Jackie did for the advancement of individual rights here in America and around the world.
Being able to win it at home in St. Louis, to be there with all the guys that had just worked so hard to make it happen.
Gary Sheffield with his 500th career home run.
Granderson caught it. Oh, my.
Can you believe that catch?
Irvin Magic Johnson, part owner of the Los Angeles Dodgers.
The brothers go back to back.
Good. Dodgers force a game seven.
Formula One drivers have nothing on Jazz Chisholm Jr.
Swing and a miss. He just keeps on punching them out.
This past December, Major League Baseball announced that the Negro Leagues would finally be given Major League status, along with their statistics and records.
Hits it in the air to right, and the White Sox win it!
When you think of all the records that have fallen related to black baseball players, that didn't have to start in 1947. It could have started in 1907. It could have started in 1887.